Today we will learn about something which is called accrual schemes. It is available in GL. This is for advance expense or advance collection or revenue. This is a very nice feature. So first we will define general in the general ledger one of the accrual for rent expense. So we will define, we will name it the identification of prepaid expense. This prepaid expense is when we pay advance rent for example 12 months. We will give a simple description, prepaid expense. Then in the prepaid expense accrual, then in the debit and the credit field, we will define temporary account which are of type balance sheet. For this kind, we will choose prepaid other expenses. This is kind of an asset account or a balance sheet account. In the credit also, we define the similar account, same account exactly. And prepaid other expense. Okay, now in the voucher, we can define same voucher for all transaction. In the description, we will give the same description, prepaid expense. Okay, and in the accrual basis, calendar or fiscal or allocation key is available. We'll choose calendar, which is actual, and then in period frequency monthly, and 12 months we'll define in the month. The transaction will be posted on the monthly basis at the end of each month, so we'll choose end in the post week, month or quarter, and it will be evenly. So this is the basic definition for prepaid expense accrual. Actually, the expense has to be realized when it has actually happened, not in the month when we pay it. So first we'll now come to accounts payable. Accounts payable will create one of the invoice journal where we will choose vendor to post a liability against vendor in terms of credit to payable and debit into the temporary account. So we'll just define header description for prepaid rent expense. Then in the lines, we'll give a date, for example 1st of November, and in the vendor we have to choose a vendor to whom we are paying this prepaid expense, rental expense. So we will select the vendor. So once vendor is selected, we will give an invoice date also. So this invoice date is actually what is printed on the vendor invoice, and the first date was the transaction date. We'll give any invoice number which has to be actual one once it is actual invoice, but for the sake of training we'll give any description here, and this will be prepaid rent for 12 months. And in the credit, so the vendor will be credited, of course. We'll give an amount of 12,000 USD. So 1,000 has to be for monthly rent, so it is annual 12,000. And here we will define the temporary control account, which is prepaid other expenses, which is kind of balance sheet or asset account. So this is the same account which we have defined in the accrual scheme. So once we define this account, so debit will be to this account. So this will be balance sheet, and since it advance rent paid, so it is our asset, so it will not be realized as expense immediately once we post this one. And we will use accrual scheme to realize as per month basis on equal basis. So here we'll remove everything else. We'll make it simple. Cash discount is removed, and we'll make it terms of payment as cash. Okay, so this is our final vendor invoice, and we'll see the print preview to check how the journal entries will go. Okay, so we'll press OK. So it's loading, and so now this is very clear that vendor is credited by $12,000 to create a liability, and the temporary account prepaid other expense, which is a balance sheet type, it is debited, so that expense is not realized at first month by this $12,000 amount, which is actually annual rental expense. So once this one, we will post it. Invoice channel will be posted immediately, but it will not affect the profit and loss at this moment. It will only hold this amount in a temporary account, and then we'll use that temporary account to realize each month for monthly expense of $1,000. So we will also check the voucher for this posted invoice, and this voucher will show us the ledger effect, and it is showing us ledger effect that accounts payable, other, and prepaid other expense. Okay, now we'll go to GL, and we'll create one JV. Okay, so we'll create a new JV. We'll give the description. Prepaid rent accrual, and then we'll go to the lines. In the lines, we'll change the date as for our previous invoice, so it will be again 1st of November, and then first account will be our charge account or the expense account, which has to be actual rent expense. So you can see this is 605150 rent expense, which is a P&L account. So, and the other account will be our temporary account, where we have posted our invoice journal from payable module. So here we will choose prepaid other expense, where we have debited actually before in account payable, and now we will be crediting each month. So we will define here in the debit side 12,000. So actually it will not happen, because we will apply accrual scheme. Here we have given 1st of November date, and we are debiting the rental expense account by 12,000, which will actually not happen, because we will apply accrual scheme here, which will be dividing all of this amount into monthly basis, the criteria which we have already defined. So this is our JV entry, and now we will see how we'll apply accrual scheme. So go into functions at the line level, and then choose ledger accrual. Here we'll choose this prepaid expense accrual, which we have just defined before this JV. And here you can see main account is ledger expense. We'll see the transaction. In the transaction, it's very clear that it has divided 12,000 amount into monthly basis, and debiting the expense account and crediting the temporary account, which is actually other prepaid other expense. So we will check also the journal entries once we have applied the accrual scheme. In the journal entries, it will show us how it has divided So here are the entries. It is very clear. First of two entries are debit and credit into the same temporary account, so it will have no effect at all. Then these are monthly entries at the end of month, since we have chosen this option in accrual scheme. 30th of November, then 31st of December, whatever is the last date, the expense will be realized in that one. So expense and P&L is debited and credit goes to the temporary account of accrual. So this is our, we'll pause this JV. So now JV is posted. You can see also the voucher. Somehow this voucher is only showing this 12,000 as a single entry. But this JV number 813, it will be in the voucher transaction in GL. It will show all entries. We'll see how it goes. We'll go to GL. Here it is. In the voucher transaction, we will put the voucher number which we have copied before, 813, and we'll press OK, and it will filter and show us all the entries, the P&L side as well. So it's very clear that rent expense is debited month wise, and prepaid other expense, which was our temporary account, is credited month wise. So this is the correct accounting. Whenever the actual expense has happened, we are realizing expense into only that month once it has completed. So that's all for now. Thank you.